Welcome to the next video on how to set up the Oracle Database, Oracle Data Guard on 19c. The first video covered the overview or the steps. This is the second video in this particular series of videos where I will be explaining how to create the primary database. If you already know how to create a primary database, you can skip to the next video. But there are some settings that you need to know. And if you already know again what are those settings, you can skip. But if you don't know, hang on and watch this video. So what I have got is I want to configure the data guard in such a way that my unique name, the requirement of the data guard is the DB name has to be same, but the unique name has to be different for every standby. So the primary, what I've done is on the primary, my DB name, the DB name is same. But on the unique name is Oracle DP, P for primary, and on standby, my unique name is Oracle DS. And what we also need to do is we need to make sure that our database is in archive log mode. We have enabled the force logging to capture all of the changes in redo log. We have to enable the flashback on, which helps in fast start failover and the standby, snapshot standby. And then we will be creating the P file, and all of these three settings actually are required to set up the standby, so they are not required. So in this particular tutorial, we will only be considering on the settings which are required on the primary database. And what I have done already is I have got our database which has already been created. So let me show it to you. So this is the database, and if I connect to that particular database and run this particular query, so if I run this particular query, I get this output. So the database name is Oracle D and unique name is also the same. But as I said, my unique name, I wanted to keep as Oracle DP. So I need to change the unique name. My database is in no archive log mode, but the requirement is the database has to be archive log, which means I need to convert the database in from the no archive log to archive log. My flashback on is no, which I had to make it S, which means I had to turn it on. And force logging is no, which means I had to turn it on. So although the database has been created, but none of the settings which are required for the data guard have been applied. So what I have here is I have a small script which I have already created, and that particular script I'm going to show it to you. So this is the script, and this particular script does set that parameters which are required at the primary side. So to convert the database into archive log mode, we will be setting the log arc-1 parameter for local archiving, and then we will be saying alter database archive log. The unique name, currently DB unique name is same as the database name, so I would be changing that as well, Oracle DP. So I'll be changing from Oracle D to Oracle DP. I will be turning on the force logging. I will be turning on the flashback. And then these are some of the other parameters such as log archmec processes or archive format and local listener. So these are the settings that we need to do on the primary side. So let me start this particular script on the primary. So let me take this particular script and make sure that I'm on primary. So show parameter. Okay, I can't. So let me exit and make sure, yeah, I am on primary. So let me clear the screen, connect to the database as sysdba and run that particular script which converts the database into archive log mode. It turns on the flashback, it turns on the force logging, and it changes the unique name from Oracle D to Oracle DP. So it's going to do that. So it's going to take some bit of time. So what I'll do is like I'll just pause the video and I'll come back. So looks like I am about, the P file has been created. So let me show you the database. Initially it was the database was now the unique name was Oracle D, and that's changed to Oracle DP unique name. The archive mode, the database has been converted to archive mode here, and P file, and right now it is the finally the P file has been created. This P file is what we have created using create pfile from spfile command, and this pfile will be copied to standby and we will edit the parameter. So now if I connect to this particular instance, remember this, it was Oracle D, no archive log, no. And let me run the same query back on the same instance. And if you see, from Oracle D, it is Oracle DP. From no archive log, it is archive log. Flashback has been turned on and forced logging has been turned on. And how I have done that? So if I have to show you those steps once again, so I'll just show it to you. So what I've done is, like, I've used the alter system command to set the DB unique name, service name also I have changed. Then I have set the log arc-1 parameter. Then I have started the database in mount mode, alter database archive log, then turned on forced logging, then set some FRA parameters, and then set the flashback retention target and turned on the flashback on. So this is what has been done till now on the primary, and our primary is now ready to be backed up and copied to the standby. And since I am using the active RMAN duplication, so the way it is doing is RMAN active duplication, there is no requirement to take the backup of primary. And in the next video, we will be starting with on the standby what we need to do, and that would be the biggest video, because in that particular video we will be creating the standby, we will be changing the data guard parameters on the primary, we will be changing the data guard parameters on the standby, we will be enabling the MRP, and also we will be doing the testing. So that video will finish our data guard setup on two databases, Oracle DP and Oracle DS. The next videos would cover the data guard broker and fast start failover, which is not mandatory. The data guard will still work without this, but it helps in management, and without data guard broker you cannot set the fast start failover. Now let's move to the next video, and I'll pause here, and I will see you in the next video of what we need to do on the standby. Right now what we have done is we have just created our primary, which was already been created. I have configured the database in archive log mode, turned on the flashback, and turned on the forced logging. Thank you for watching. See you in next video. Bye bye.